The National Park Service enters its second century in a perilous position. My name is Tim Whitehouse. I am the Executive Director of Public Employees for Environmental Responsibility, known to many of you as PEER. We are a not-for-profit that supports whistleblowers and works with current and former public employees to fight for natural resources and strong environmental protections. PEER launched a campaign called Beyond 2020 to look at how we can improve the workings of federal agencies such as the National Park Service. The Park Service is now responsible for more than 85 million acres of land, almost an area the size of Montana. It has 420 diverse units, including parks such as the 186-mile C&O Canal and Towpath in Maryland, which is just behind me, to battlefields, monuments, seashores, scenic trails, and recreation areas. Sadly, the national park system is under assault from commercial intrusion, overuse, poor planning, and the lack of visionary leadership. Our piece, Beyond 2020, the National Park System, highlights some issues we think the Park Service needs to address in the coming years. One issue that needs to be addressed is leadership. Astonishingly, the Trump administration has never nominated a Park Service director for Senate confirmation. This has left the agency adrift and subject to political manipulation. That needs to change. But that's just the top. So much more needs to be done. Another issue is public participation and long-term planning. The Park Service should develop long-term management plans for each major park and involve the public in those plans. Of the 108 major units of the park system, by our count, only 51 have current general management plans. That is not acceptable. The public deserves to have more of a say in how their parks are managed. We also need to expand and protect park wilderness areas. National Park Wilderness contains some of the most magnificent wildlands in the nation, and for that matter, the world. Yet the Park Service has repeatedly failed to live up to its commitment to protect and continue to designate wilderness areas. Another important suggestion is to reignite the Green Parks Program. This program, proposed under the Obama administration but never implemented, would have required parks to enhance wildlife protection, increase recycling, and eliminate most plastics. Because of opposition from well-heeled lobbyists, it was never implemented. It's time to reestablish that. Our Beyond 2020 work has more suggestions, like steps the Park Service should take to reclaim park skies from noisy and excessive park tours, stop a decline in the number of park rangers, and temporarily halt new cell towers and other encroachments into the backcountry. I am now on the Monocacy Aqueduct, which is part of the C&O Canal. This is one of the countless treasures of our national park system. From Yosemite to the Grand Canyon, to the Smoky Mountains, to our wonderful parks in Alaska and Hawaii, our park system is worth fighting for and protecting. The national park system was once called America's best idea. Let's help keep it that way by supporting the parks, the staff, and those like PEER who work to defend it. Visit our website to learn more about PEER and Beyond 2020, the National Park System. Thank you for watching.